So when we're painting aluminum siding, one of the most important things to paint aluminum siding properly is to make sure that it is pressure washed completely. Aluminum siding, especially older aluminum siding, it tends to, the coating that's on it tends to oxidize and you get a chalky residue. Now before you paint it, you have to pressure wash it and make sure that chalky residue is gone. How do you make sure it's gone? Just run your hand over it. If there's no chalky residue on your hand, you're ready to paint. So what we're doing here, the house gets pressure washed, and in some cases, in a lot of cases, the shutters are not decided that they're going to be removed until after. And we have to make sure that it's clean everywhere, including behind the shutters. So what we do is we take a solvent and we wipe down behind the shutters to make sure that we get any residue, any dirt, any dust, debris off, so that we make sure that the paint bonds and adheres properly. And that's what Mark's doing here. Another thing that we do with these windows, in an area like this, we scrape the wood to make sure that all the loose paint is off, and then we run a bead of caulk in here to make sure that it's nice and tight. You want to make sure that that's waterproofed and no water can get in behind there and cause any damage inside of that wall. So after we get all the trim scraped and caulked up, we throw a coat of an oil-based primer down. And the reason we use an oil-based primer, it stops the tannin bleed, and the alkyd resin that makes up an oil-based primer bonds to the surface much better than an acrylic. So you'll block out any staining and you'll get a better bond. And it just, honestly, it weatherproofs the wood better than an acrylic paint will. And we'll come back over this and top coat it with an acrylic paint after everything's done. But for now, put some primer down to make sure we get it sealed up nice and tight. So on the back of this house, this is a door that you can clearly see was left go and delaminated. This is another thing that we can take care of for you. While we're here doing the painting work, we have the carpenter coming and he's going to change out this door, put in a nice new steel door. It'll be sealed up nice and tight. We'll get a coat of paint on it and it'll look good as new. These metal railings, you can see there's a lot of coats of paint on here and it's failing and there's rust coming through and they're in really bad shape. Any place you have dissimilar metals coming together, you've got a steel galvanized with different kind of bolts. They were probably steel and they maybe were plated with something, maybe they weren't. But dissimilar metals come together and that causes rust when two dissimilar metals touch. You've got a million points where dissimilar metals are coming together on this stairway. So what we've got to do to stop that is remove all the loose peeling paint, as much of that loose rust as possible. We encapsulate that with a rust inhibitive primer or something that completely blocks the moisture. And what we're going to use in this case is an mastic epoxy will go on all the rusted areas to completely encapsulate so that no moisture can touch that metal anymore. And then we'll come over top of the whole thing with a typical oil-based type of paint, you know, like Rust-Oleum and alkyd oil-based paint. And that'll give you a good seal over top of everything. But we go a little extra where you have dissimilar metals coming together or already rusted areas to make sure that that stops the moisture from getting to the rust and causing more.